Hello everyone, welcome to Unacademy. My name is Amit Sudhana, a plus educator on Unacademy, teaching students live on Unacademy Plus for CAT exam preparation. In this session today, I'm going to discuss with you the tricks to solve the actual math quant questions, and I will be teaching you the tricks of solving these questions under 30 seconds. So here is the first question that we will be discussing. Let's have a look at it. So here's a question number one. This is an actual math paper question. It says in a mathematics exam, a student scored 30% in the first paper out of total 180. How much should he score in the second paper out of 150 if he is to get at least 50% marks overall? So his minimum target is to get at least 50% overall, and he's giving two paper. You see that the two paper are of 180 plus 150 marks, that you can do it mentally, that the total marks is 330, and his target is to get 50%, that is half of these marks, which is equivalent to 165. And he has already got 30% out of 180. That means out of 160, he has already scored 54. 30% of 180 is 54. So he's supposed to get 111 more marks out of 111 more marks out of 150. And you can see that if you look at the options, 75%, 80, 74, and 84%, you see that 80% of 150, right? You can do it mentally, that 80% of 150 is 120. I'm supposed to find out 111 as a percentage of 150. So answer is definitely less than 80%. These two options are straight away eliminated. These two options I'm left with. And because 75%, you see that 150 into 3/4, is 450/4, which is equivalent to 112 point something, right? And I'm supposed to find out 111 as a percentage of 150. So see that this is also less than 75%. So this option is also eliminated. You're left with option number C. That's the correct answer of the question. You need to use the options to answer the questions quickly. Now let's have a look at the second question. So guys, here's a question number two. It says a milkman buys milk contained in 10 vessels of equal size. If he sells his milk at rupees 5 a liter, he loses rupees 200. If he sells it at rupees 6 a liter, he would gain 150 on the whole. Find the number of liters contained in each vessel. So see that, guys, the total number of vessels are 10, right? And all of the vessels are of equal size. So if I'm assuming that every vessel is containing X liter, so the total liter that he's selling is 10X. When he's selling at 5 rupees a liter, right, the total money that he's getting is 50X. And when he will be selling the whole milk at 6 rupees a liter, he will be selling it at 60X. And you see that at this point of, on this rupees, he's losing 200, and over here, he's gaining 150. That means The difference between these two value is of 350, a loss of 200 and gain of 150. You see that? Let's say this is a cost price here. The loss of 200 means this is my selling price, and gain of 150 means this is my selling price. A selling price in case of gain will be more than cost price, and a selling price in case of loss will be less than cost price. So 200 loss and 150 gain is equivalent to 350. So straight away you can see that the difference between 60x minus 50x will be equal to 350. That is 10x is equal to 350. X, that means in every container, the milk is of 35 liter. So D would be the correct answer of the question. Let's move on to the next question. So guys, here is the question number four. It says a man buys apple at a certain price per dozen and sell them at 8 times per 100. What is the meaning of this statement? When I say that a man buy apples at a certain price per dozen, it means let's assume that one apple is being purchased at, let's say, 1 rupee, right? One apple is being purchased at 1 rupee. Now the man is buying these apples at a certain price per dozen, right? So you can see that if one apple is being purchased at 1 rupees, 12 apple will be purchased at 12 rupees. So that means per dozen price is rupees 12, right? So rupees 12 is a per dozen price. And he sells at 8 times per 100. So he's selling 100 apples, right? So I have assumed that one apple is being sold at purchased at 1 rupees. So can I say that 100 apples is being purchased at 100 rupees? So now because he's selling at 8 times per 100, right? 8 times per 100. That means 8 times of this price. 12 rupees per dozen is a cost price. 8 times of this price. That means he's selling the 100 apple at 8 times of per dozen price. That means at 96. So he's purchasing something at 100 rupees and selling this at 96. So you can see that there's a loss of 4 rupees over the investment of 100. So you can say that there's a loss of 4%. Option A would be the correct answer of the question. Moving on to the next question, let's have a look at it. So guys, here is the question number 5. It says 16 January 1997 was a Thursday. What day of the week was 4th of January 2000? See this, guys. 1997 was Thursday, right? All you need to know to solve this set, to solve this question, is the concept of odd number of days, right? The concept of odd number of days. You see that if I'm saying that 16th January 1997 is Thursday. So can I say that if I go to the next year, 16th January 1998, right? There's a gap of 365 days. So if I want to find out the odd number of days, you just need to divide it by 7 and find out the remainder. Remainder is 1. So you can say that on 16th January 1998, the day would be plus 1. The remainder is 1. So Thursday plus 1, the day would be Friday. If I go to 16th January 1999, again, the number of days will get increased to 365. Again, the odd days will be 1. So the day would be Saturday. If I go to 2000, right, till 16th January 2000, again, I'm moving by 365 number of days. So it will be again, now it will be Sunday, right? So on 16th January 2000, I have Sunday, but I'm supposed to tell the day on the 4th of January 2000. Now you see that, guys, 16th January 2000 is Sunday, right? So can I say that if I decrease it by 7 number of days, that means 9th January 2000 will also be Sunday. 2nd January will also be Sunday. If 2nd January is Sunday, 3rd January will be Monday. And the 4th January will be equal to Tuesday. So that's the answer to the question. Option A would be the correct answer for this question. Moving on to the next question, guys. So guys, the question number 6 of the previous year math paper is, out of a group of swans, the 7/2 times the square root of the numbers are playing on the shore of the pond. The complete solution lies in this line. You need to understand the statement, the out of the total number of swans, right? 7/2 times the square root of the total number of swans are on the shore of the pond, and the remaining two are inside the pond. That is equal to the total number of swans in the pond, right? That's it. This is the equation that I need to solve, which you can easily solve, right? Straight away, you can see that out of these options, if I have to put any value here, I need an n to be a perfect square. So straight away, the best possible answer to check is the option number D. If I check it with the option number D, 7/2 times of root 16 plus 2 is equal to 16. Let's check it. Now root 16 is 8, right? If I say the total number of swans are equal to, total number of swans are equal to 16, right? So root 16 is 4. This will cancel it on 2. 7 into 2 plus 2 is 16. That is 16 is equal to 16. So this option satisfied it. Anyways, the perfect square has to be the answer because it's talk about the square root of the number of swans, right? The total number of swans. So the only one option is a perfect square. That is option number D. So without even trying it, you can straight away answer the question as option number D. Moving on to the next question. So guys, here's a question number 7. It says a wooden box of dimension 8 meters, 7 meters, 6 meters is to carry rectangular boxes of dimension 8 centimeter into 7 centimeter and 6 centimeter. The maximum number of boxes that can be carried in the wooden box. A very simple question. You see that if I'm supposed to put the number of boxes with a dimension of 8 centimeter into 7 centimeter into 6 centimeter in this box, the volume should be same. So the number of these boxes are n, and every box is having the volume of 8 into 7 into 6 centimeter cube. it should be equal to the volume of this large box, which is 8 into 7 into 6 meter cube. So to answer this question, you see that all these value will get cancelled. The numbers will depend on meter cube upon centimeter cube. And we know that in 1 meter, the centimeters are 100, right? So this is 100 into 100 into 100. The number of small boxes will be 10 raised to power 6. 1 followed by 60 is the correct answer. That is option number B. Option B is the correct answer of the question. Moving on to the next question, guys. So guys, the question number 8 is from height and distance topic of trigonometry. It says the horizontal distance between two towers is 16 meter. The angular elevation of the top of the taller tower as seen from the top of the shorter one is 30 degree. So we have two towers, right? One is a large one and one is a smaller one, right? And it says the angular elevation of the top of the taller tower as seen from the top of the shorter one is 30 degrees. So this angle is given to you as 60 degrees. AB is the large one, right? The taller tower. CD is a smaller tower, right? And this angular elevation is 30 degrees. The height of the taller tower is 150. This whole distance is 150 meter. I'm supposed to find out the height of a shorter one. Assuming that the height of the shorter one is H. Let's say this is H. So you can see that this height would be 150 minus H. That means AE is 150 minus H. This angle is 30, this is 90, this is 60 degrees. You can straight away answer this question very easily. The distance between two towers is given to you as 60 meter. That means this distance is 60. And see that this triangle is a 30, 60, 90. In a 30, 60, 90, you should know that as per the sine rule, the side ratio would be 1:3:2. Now in this triangle, if I apply this, right side opposite to 30 degrees, and side opposite to 60 degrees are in the ratio 1:3. Side opposite to 30 degrees is 150 minus H, and side opposite to 60 degrees is 60. Now this should be in the ratio 1:3. That's it. You're supposed to find out the height H now to answer this question, right? So either you can solve this or you can just put the values from the option that which of these options will give you the height as so that the ratio comes out to be 1/3. Let's try to solve this. So see that 150 minus H would be 60/3. This can be rationalized. This will cancel it on 20. So see that H would be 150 minus 20/3. 150 minus 20. Root 3 is 1.732. So this is 150 minus approximately 34. This is giving you the answer as 116. A option will be the correct answer of this question. Let's move on to the question number 9. So guys, the question number 9 is from time, speed and distance. It says an aeroplane traveled a distance of 2500 meter, 1200 kilometer and 500 kilometer at a speed of 500 kilometer per hour, 400 kilometer per hour and 250 kilometer per hour respectively. The average speed is what? Very simple question, right? So you can straight away see that average speed is total distance traveled upon total time taken. That's it. This is all you need to know, right? The total distance travel upon total time. See, the total distance travel is 2500 plus 500, 300 plus 1200, that is 4200 kilometer. And the total time is 2500 at a speed of 500 will take 5 hours. 1200 at a speed of 400 will take 3 hours. 500 at a speed of 250 will take 2 hours. So average speed would be 4200 upon 10. You can straight away answer the 420 kilometer per hour, which is option number A. So option A is the correct answer of the question. Let's move on to question number 10. So guys, here in the next question is from average and you can straight away solve it. It says that 35 students in a hostel, if the number of students increases by 7, the expenses of the mess increases by rupees 42 per day, while the average expenditure per head diminished by rupees 1, the find the original expenditure of the mess. You can solve this question without making an equation. You see that initially the number of students in the hostel are 35. Now the number of students are 42. And because of this, the expenditure gets increased by 42, but average expenditure get reduced by rupees 1. That means these 35 students are now spending 1 rupees less, and also the increased expenditure of 42 is now being taken care of the 7 extra students that are coming. That means these 7 students are doing the expenditure of 35 rupees plus increased expenditure of 42. That means these 7 students are taking care of the expenditure of 77 that give you the new average of 11. And this new average of 11 is one less than the previous average. The previous average, because this new average is one less than the previous average. So therefore, the original average, see that original average must have been 11 plus 1, that is 12. And if I want to find out, the original expenditure of the mess, it will be equal to, so that means 35 students on an average are spending 12 rupees. So total expenditure would be 360 plus 60, which is equal to 420. So original expenditure of the mess would be C option. That is the correct answer of the question. So guys, here's a question number 12. It says, the ratio between the number of passengers traveling by first and second class between the two railway station is 1:50. So the number of students between class 1 and class 2 is in the ratio 1:50. The ratio first and second class fare, right? That is the money, that means the ticket charge is in the ratio, right? Or you can say the price of the ticket is in the ratio of 3:1. So if one passenger is traveling from class 1, he's paying 3 rupees. So you can see that revenue collection from the first class would be 3 rupees and the revenue collection from the second class would be 15:1, that is 50 rupees. That's the revenue ratio. On a particular day, 1,325 were collected from the passenger traveling between these stations. Now this 1,325 is a total revenue collection. So you can see that if 3 rupees is coming from here, 50 rupees will be coming from here. So total collection is 53 rupees. If this total collection is now given to you as 1,325, you can see that this is how much time? You just need to divide 1,325 by 53 rupees, right? This will be 106, 12 minus 6 is 6, 265. So yes, this is 25 times. So that is, this is becoming 25 times. So you can see that the amount collected from the second class passenger would be 50 × 25, that is 1,250. And the amount collected from the first class passenger would be 75 rupees. So second class passengers are paying 1,250. That's the correct answer of the question. Guys, question number 13 says a fuel indicator in a car shows 1/5 of the fuel tank as full. When 22 more liters of the fuel are poured into the tank, that indicator rests at 3/4 of the full mark. That means initially the indicator is 20% of the full tank, and after adding 22 more liters, it is showing 75% of the full tank. That means, can I say that this 22 liter is nothing but 55% of the total capacity, right? So 5 × 11, 5 × 20, this cancel it on 2. That means the total capacity of the tank is 40 liter. D option is the correct answer of the question. Moving on to the next question, guys. So guys, in the question number 14, it says that a sum of money is accumulating at compound interest at certain rate of interest. If simple interest instead of compound were reckoned, the interest for the first 2 years would be diminished by rupees 20, and that for the first 3 years, it will get diminished by 61. Find the sum. See guys, to solve this question, the straightaway shortcut that you can apply is that when I'm thinking about simple interest and compound interest, right? The first year, the interest value is same, right? So whatever is the interest value, right? Whatever the simple interest that you're getting in the first year, it will be same. Right, in the second year SI will be same as in the first year, but in the compound interest you will be getting X rupees plus there will be additional amount that you'll be getting, which will be the interest on interest. And because the difference between 2 years of SI and CI is 20, so can I say the extra value that you're getting here is of 20? And if I go to the third year, the interest value on the principal will be X. Compound interest also you will be getting X on principal, but in addition to that you will be getting this 20 rupees again in the third year as an interest on this X rupees. And also you will be getting 20 rupees more as an interest on this rupees. Now, because the difference between 3 year is given to you as 61, and this point of time, I can see the difference between between 3 years of SI and CI is 60 rupees. But if the difference is 61, that means an extra 1 rupees has been earned on an interest of 20. This 1 rupees is an interest on the previous year interest of second year, previous year extra interest of second year. So 1 rupees on 20 will tell you that you are earning 5% rate of interest. That means the rate of interest in this case, in this question, is 5%. So that means if I say that the rate of interest is 5%, so this 20 is 5% of X value, right? This 20 is nothing but 5% of X. So X into 5% is equal to 20. That means this X is equal to 400. So in the first year, you are getting 400 rupees as an interest. And this interest has been earned on the principal value P. And rate of interest, as we have already seen, is 5%. So 5% of the principal will be 400. This cancel it on 20. So you'll get the principal value equal to 8,000. That's the correct answer of the question. Moving on to the next question. So guys, that's it for the day. Thank you so much for joining the session. And there's an announcement here. The price hike is coming soon on Unacademy. Students who wish to prepare for CAT 2021 or for other MBA entrance exams on Unacademy Plus must join the Unacademy Plus as soon as possible. The charges for 1 month duration will be increased to 4,100 rupees per month. Three month, which was earlier 8,750, will now be charged at 10,250. Similarly, there's a hike in 6 month subscription, 12 month subscription, as well as in 12 month subscription. You can use my referral code LRDI Samir Live to join Unacademy Plus. This will give you a 10% off on Unacademy Plus subscription. Also, on 21st of March, there will be a scholarship test that will be conducted, right? And you can join this scholarship test on 21st of March. The link of the test is given in the description part of this video, where you can get a chance to win the scholarship up to 55 lakh rupees. Thank you so much for watching this session, guys. See you in the next part.